Hey, look at that, I made myself a Slurpee! Top 10 things not to do in soldering! This is a safety video and nobody really likes safety videos, so we're gonna go really fast. Number 10! Make sure that you wear pants, because if you have the soldering iron in your hand and you drop it in your lap and you are sitting down, it's really going to hurt because you don't have your legs protected. And at the very least, make sure you wear underwear, because then you're protecting your naughty bits. And also, if you're sitting in a chair that somebody else might be sitting in and you're not wearing underwear, that's like really gross, so don't do that. Number 9. Even though I'm rushing through this video, you shouldn't rush when you use solder. Take your time and get it right. It's also better not to burn yourself, and we know that that sucks, so don't do that. Number 8. When you're done, make sure you always unplug your soldering iron, just like your glue gun. Even if it has an on-off switch, better safe than sorry. Number 7. Don't try soldering with lead-free solder first. Try the regular solder, and that way you know what you're doing before you go to the lead-free solder, because the lead-free solder has a way higher melting point, and you have more of a chance burning yourself if you're not really sure what you're doing. Number 6. Don't buy acid flux solder. It is not for crafts, it is not for electronics, it is for plumbing. Number 5. You want to wash your hands, both before you solder and after you solder. The reason you want to wash your hands before you solder is you want to make sure you don't get any oils or any of the other materials that might be on your hand on the thing that you're trying to solder, because then your solder won't stick. The reason that you wash your hands after you solder is you want to make sure that you get rid of any lead or any extraneous materials from the soldering or the board that you're touching, because you don't want to wind up having those on the things that you're eating and then accidentally ingesting them. Number 4. Don't flick off your solder. The reason you don't want to flick off your solder is because, well, not only is it hot, but there are some things that it doesn't come out of. You'll see videos where people are like, here's how you clean it, flick, flick. But believe me, there will be screams. Either people who are hurt or people who are going to be really mad at you because they can't get the solder out of great Aunt Gertrude's handmade quilt. Number 3. Do not solder in a small space. The reason that I say this is because, you know, if you decide you're going to solder in a shoebox or a closet or something like that, there's smoke that comes off of it. The smoke will accumulate, and you don't necessarily want to be breathing it in the whole time. Just make sure you use it in a well-ventilated area. It's not noxious, it's not toxic, but better to be safe than sorry. Number 2. Once you are done learning how to solder and you are ready to make things, and you're going to make something like jewelry or you're going to be using it for silverware, make sure that you use lead-free solder. Anything that will be coming in contact with somebody's hand before they are eating is a really bad idea to use lead on, because they might accidentally ingest it. So don't do that, number 1. Don't forget to put your soldering iron back in the holder. If you put it on the table, it might roll off. If it rolls off the table, the first thing you're going to do is want to grab it. If you grab it, you're going to grab it by the barrel. You're going to have a big nasty scar all the way across here. It's going to hurt for a really long time. It's going to bubble. It might get infected. Nobody wants that. If for some reason it does fall off the table, do not grab it. You're going to want to. It looks like a pencil. You just want to. Don't do that. Let it fall to the ground. Move everything else out of the way. Yourself, small children, animals, everything else. Let it burn a hole in the carpet. Way better than burning a hole in you. Are there more than 10 safety things you should know? Yes, a lot of them are the same as the glue gun one. I'm going to link it over here. If you haven't watched it yet, you should watch that. If this video has been helpful, make sure that you give it a thumbs up, or at the very least, subscribe if you haven't yet. If you have a question, leave it in the comments below. I will get back to you as soon as I can. And that's it for now. The next video is going to be covering soldering irons, and I will see you guys then. Okay, bye!